What's happening, guys? What's happening? Welcome back to our YouTube channel. Once again, this is your one and only doctor in Forex. This is Dr. Martin. And this video is slightly different. I want to take you guys through my normal morning routine and how I would look at the markets and stuff like that. So first of all, the time is 11:53. I literally just woke up not so long ago. And I'm only going to start with my daily routine now. So as you guys can see, I'm only opening my laptop right now. And the first thing that you obviously want to do is you want to firstly go to your browser. So that's the first thing I do when I wake up. Go to my browser, go to my scriptures. I read my daily verses. And today's verse was Mark chapter 5 and verse 21. You can obviously go read that when you do have your own time. That's the first thing I do. Secondly, I go and I look at the website, look at a few things on the website, see what new inquiries we do have. Go to my emails to check as well, which I obviously cannot open right now. And go to my YouTube as well to check as well. And lastly, go to my charts to see what we do have. So this is the main business of today. And this is what I want to do with you guys. And hopefully you guys will see a thing or two on what I am trying to do today. It's not going to be a long video. It's going to be a really short video with me explaining what I think about US 30 and stuff like that. So if you go to the smaller time frame quickly, you will notice that I did get an entry here last night. So last night I did take an entry around these levels. So my entry was exactly over there. And you can see how beautiful this trade was. Hit TP right over there. And I went to bed with the market having to hit my TP. You can see this at market opening at 12 midnight. This is when the market hit my take profit. And I entered somewhere around there. This was around 9:15 to like 12. So for a solid 3 hours, I was on this move and it hit my target over there. And this was a beautiful trade to take. So let's maybe have a look at the markets. Why was my take profit there? And what do I expect to happen from this particular market? So let me try and get a clean chart, actually. Let me try and get a clean chart and see if... I won't get to, you know, explain this whole market from a clean perspective. And I hope you guys really get to learn a thing or two, even from what I will be showing you guys today. So this is what we do have on US 30. So US 30, let's maybe try and get a bigger time frame to see and understand what we do have in perspective. So US 30, is actually quite an interesting market right now. Even though this is not my kind of move, this is not my favorite type of move to trade. I even have my glass of milk next to me, the way it's so early. Sorry, I was just taking a sip on it. So this is what we do have on US 30. US 30 has been fairly bullish, and this has been a moving market. But there's something I've actually noticed even in the past weeks. Because remember that I've been trading US 30 for like almost 2 years now. Like it's been over 1.5 years. So I'm going for my second year right now trading US 30. And I've been able to consistently monitor its behavior. So what I've noticed with US 30 is that US 30 loves ranging like this. So if you look at this, this is what you'll see, that US 30 will be ranging quite a lot. So if you look at this move over here, like US 30 was ranging a lot, faking above and below all the time. And even here, we did see that kind of movement as well. If you look at this particular market that we have over here, it's the same thing that we had over there with US 30 ranging, faking above and below, coming back in and all of that. So these are common patterns on US 30 that happen. And right now I'm seeing the same kind of movement about to form as well. So I do think that US 30 might actually be on the same tip of being stuck in a range for a couple of days. And I'm okay with it. I'm okay with it, even though it's not my favorite kind of moves, because when I started trading US 30, this was just a smoothly trending market. But right now we have seen some significant kind of ranging moves in the market. So right now, what we do have here on this market is as easy as this. So we have the market stuck within these two zone. So the market can either go up or down, go up or down. So right now, the chances of us coming down to this level are very much maximum. So I do think that we can actually plummet down to the downside, into that zone, around about 34,500, 34,450, around about these levels. And also we do have a major key level around about these regions. So I do think that we can actually come down to test these lower regions before we can actually head to the upside, because overall we are actually trending up. So I'm not scared as to what can potentially happen in the long term. I do know and understand that this is a buying market. However, on an intraday perspective, we need to consider these moves that have been created. And also we need to kind of mind the fact that we do have this level and zone as well, which is a significant area as well in the markets, because this is acting as a very strong previous high zone that the market keeps on testing. You can see how we came back to visit this level once, twice, and obviously we failed to break past the previous high, which means we can also come to revisit back this level and obviously break above. So I do expect that this market will come and obviously touch around these regions. So that's what I'm expecting, because we did see some kind of a similar behavior in previous markets. And the fact that we failed to break past this zone also gives me the confidence to know that we're going to go down. So if you look at this on its simplest form, we do have some kind of a range that's going on. So this is what we can expect in this market. And this is a move that I think is very most likely to play out. So what do we look for there that will obviously help us catch entries and moves to the downside? So the reason why I closed my entries over there was because I noticed that there was an area of sensitivity. Sorry about that. Let me just quickly go back to my charts here. There was an area of sensitivity that was happening over here, which can be clearly seen around here. So if I do this, like, you can clearly see that area of sensitivity, which was why my take profit was there. So I told you guys that I'd explain why my take profit was there. That's the reason why my take profit was there, because there was an area of sensitivity around that region. So if you then scale down to a smaller time frame, maybe let's say we go down to the hourly to see exactly how price action is being printed out in these regions, you can see that this is a level that the market has actually been respecting quite a lot. However, on the H4, this zone was drawn directly on the bodies. But on the H1, I will actually kind of modify it, because I can see that the sensitivity area is literally around here instead of it being there. So it's literally around here. So on the H1, I can basically see things in perspective. And what I can then do is that I can obviously then look at shorting US30 around these regions and levels it's at right now. And my stops would obviously be slightly above previous high. So I'm risking about 35 points to make up what, 133 points, which is a good amount of money. So this is all that I will look for on US30. And also if you look at price action as well, you can see how then the market keeps on creating significant lows as well. So you can see how then this area was actually respected and the market couldn't break past that high, even with yesterday's push to the upside. But we literally failed to break past that high, meaning that we are now setting ourselves down for a new move that would obviously push us back into the lows. So that's what I'm looking for. I'm looking at the fact that we are creating significant lows and that the market has to break past this support level that I just drew now and definitely close below. Then I can obviously start looking at shorting US 30 to 33,450. And obviously my stops being above that. So that's what I'm looking for and observing for today. And I hope you guys really enjoyed this video that I recorded. I did say this was going to be a very short video. And whilst at it, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel, like the video, subscribe to the channel, leave a comment down below. Let me know what are more things that you'd really like to learn from me. and I would be more than glad to help you. Once again, this is Dr. Martin from Regenesis Wealth Club. You know what it is. Enjoy the rest of your trading day. Bless up.